Hallo und herzlich.
Welcome to a new episode of the Twin Bush e-learning series. My name is Leander. I'm one of the Twin Bush engineers in Bensheim. Today we'll focus on the subject of valves. We have already talked about rims and tires, but they're not a good combination without a valve. The tire valve seals the tire to prevent loss of pressure. It's used to inflate and deflate air in and out of the tire.
In und aus dem Reifen.
Through the sealing and constant holding of air in the tire, it helps to minimize the wear of the tire, to minimize fuel consumption, and to ensure a safe grip on the road. The basic structure of a valve is made of the body, the valve cap, and the valve core. The valve core can be screwed out of the valve with a valve core remover. The valve core has a red seal. It seals the valve from the inside when it's inserted. The plunger is pushed down and open to pressurize or deflate the air. This plunger is pushed back to its starting position with a pressure spring and the valve is closed. In principle, it can be said that, regardless of which valve type, the valve should be renewed when changing tires. At least the valve core and the sealing rings, because it can lead to a leak. And to prevent this, the valve is usually replaced during tire fitting. Especially with rubber valves, it is also important to notice that rubber can become brittle and hard due to environmental influences such as UV radiation, and that a creeping leak can occur and the tire will gradually lose pressure. This should be avoided by replacing the valves during tire fitting. The basic or standard valve diameter is 11.3 mm. There are also smaller or bigger versions. Of course, this depends on the size of the valve hole in the rim, so it should be proofed before trying to insert a valve. When changing the valve, you should also always make sure that a valve cap is screwed on, so that no dirt, water or similar can get into the valve and cause a leak. Let's focus on the valve types. The most common and most used valve types are the rubber valve, also called Snapin valve, the metal or aluminum bolt-in valve, the truck valve, and the valve with tire pressure monitoring systems or TPMS. As a side note, the truck valve, which can be recognized by the green rim, and which is usually designed as a metal valve, they have a greater nominal pressure load. The other valves that I have mentioned so far are only permitted by law between 4 and 4.5 bar. On the subject of rubber or snap-in valves, the basic structure is made in such a way that the metallic valve body is completely covered with rubber, and it thus presents a relatively flexible valve type. The valve is also called snap-in valve because it is pulled into the rim. A valve puller can be used for this. The valve is inserted into the valve hole. The valve puller is screwed on tightly from above, and the valve is pulled up by levering on the rim flange until the valve is tightly fitted into the valve hole with the seal ring. With the rubber valves as well as all other types of valves, one has to pay attention. There are different valve lengths. How the valve is fixed and in which position depends on the type of wheel. The valve should not protrude from the edge of the wheel, because it could collide with something otherwise, which could break the valve and thus cause an air leak. This should be avoided by always matching the size of the valve to the type of wheel. Additionally, it should be noted that rubber or snap-in valves are only approved up to a maximum speed of 210 km per hour. If the car in which these valves are installed has a maximum speed higher than 210 km per hour, metal bolt-in valves would have to be used because they simply have a much higher mechanical solidity. Let's focus on the Bolton valves, in this case an aluminum valve. These come in different finishes like metallic or matte gloss among others. The basic structure is the same. There's a body, a valve cap and a valve core. In contrast to the rubber valve, this valve is bolted. This means that the valve is inserted into the provided valve hole. And it is bolted from the upper or rather outer side of the wheel. Make sure that the bolting is done following the instructions from the manufacturer. Usually 4 to 6 Newton meters tightening torque to create a seal, and not too tight to avoid damaging the material. Let's talk about the valves with tire pressure sensors. Tire pressure sensors have been a requirement for newly registered vehicles since 2014. Direct and indirect systems are permitted. I'll briefly explain the difference between the direct and indirect systems now. No special sensor system is needed for indirect measuring systems, just a normal valve. The measuring system usually works via the ABS system, or partly through the traction control as well. The principle is simply that when a tire loses pressure, the circumference of the tire decreases, and thus the rolling speed of the tire becomes greater than that of the one from the opposite side. The ABS sensors detect the speed difference, report this error to the vehicle's onboard computer and thus send the error message to the cockpit. The driver knows that there's a loss of pressure, but he doesn't know in what amount, speed or size. The direct measuring systems are better for this. Electronics are built into the valve with direct measuring systems. These are mounted on the rim barrel as well. These sensors detect or measure the physical values of air pressure, partially of tire temperature as well, and report them to the onboard computer via radio. And they can thus report correct and concrete data about air pressure and loss of pressure to the driver. As you can see, there are electronics, or a sensor system, attached to this valve, a bolt-in valve in this case. This sensor system consists of the measuring systems and a battery. This battery is integrated or cast into the sensor system. This means a battery replacement is not possible, but the manufacturers usually indicate a durability between 5 and 10 years or approximately 100,000 up to 150,000 kilometers depending on the use. This means that the sensors only send data to the vehicle during the rotation movement. If the vehicle stops, the sensors go into a standby mode and turn off. When installing the direct systems, make sure that when the valve is inserted, this is an adjustable sensor system in this case. The sensor system should be set so that it rests on the rim barrel. When mounting the tire later, it's important to push the tire into the drop center first, as mentioned in the rim video. This should be done on the side opposite the sensors, or whichever valve type, to avoid damaging it. This means, we push the tire opposite the valve over the rim flange, and into the drop center in order to push the tire over the flange on the valve side without damaging the valve or the sensor system.